Match game 74, production number 0220. Take one. Get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Abby Dalton. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded big money match game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Well, well.
I greet you and welcome you, one and all.
You know, you would have made a great emperor.
Yes, I am.
Some poverty-stricken country.
Down with the peasants.
I'm a stranger in town. Could you direct me to the carnival?
That was just a little humor.
Listen, I don't know whether the studio audience or our TV audience had a chance to see it, but would you stand up, please? And
thanks, everybody's.
That's...
Zazu,
it looks like Zazu Pitts.
No, no, this is Brett before she had her face done.
What did she say?
A little touch of humor, Brett. You know we love you.
Working
out a wig and all, we think you're terrific.
Okay. We love you, hon.
Here we go.
Let's keep my face in place.
Those are big eyes, aren't
they? Here are two players, Karen O'Day and Diane Jones.
Yeah.
All right, Karen. Karen's a current champ with $10,000, and we just started the game last time out with Diane challenging her. She had her question, did not score. We've got a question for you in round one, and we'll get to that right after we get to a couple of commercials here. Okay, let's push this button and reveal the second half of round one for you, Karen. Karen O'Day, we've got this for you. Everybody plays. Ready?
Okay.
Dick Tracy said,
Yes.
I traded in my wrist radio for a wrist television. That's why I've got this huge antenna sticking out of my blank. He said, Dick Tracy. You know who Dick Tracy is? I traded in my wrist radio for a wrist television, and that's why I've got this huge antenna sticking out of my blank. Okay.
Oh, mercy,
I'm that's so an easy nice. One, right, Brett?
Certainly is.
Well, do it.
I hear from Morrison is... All week
long. Well, we'll find out. Wait a minute now. We'll find out what... First, Karen O'Day has to give us a response. Dick Tracy said, I traded in my wrist radio for a wrist television. Remember, he was the first one with the wrist... You remember that? And that's why I've got this huge antenna sticking out of my blank.
Head.
She said, with a question mark in her voice, head.
What was Dick Tracy's sweetheart's name?
Her name was, what's that?
Lola Lane.
Apple Mary.
Truheart.
Tess Truheart.
And his friend was Pat Patton.
That's right.
And that rotten kid was Junior.
Yeah.
I'll tell you everything.
Yeah. Well, except the right answer, sticking out of his pants.
Out of his pants, okay.
He had the unmitigated gall to make fun of my answer.
Where did you see it? Is it a beauty?
It's terrific. It's where you put a flag. Right up your navel.
Then, oh, yeah. That's right. When you carry the flag, they have those belts.
Da, 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 da,
that's enough of that.
Or a duck, maybe somebody's mother. Take the next chorus.
Take it, Charles.
She's a very sick lady.
Head!
Head! Okay. A little head.
Well,
you have one?
What?
Now he has to find another place to put his carrot. Because he had to move it to put that in his ear.
In his ear. The antenna sticking right out of his ear there. Okay. Dick Tracy is a trader. Wrist radio. Wrist tester. We've got this huge antenna sticking out of my...
Didn't he always wear a chapeau?
Yeah, he did. He always had a fedora.
That's where the aerial came out of his hat.
Out of his hat.
You don't stick it in your head, don't you?
They match that. They match hat and head. Okay.
You're very kind. Thank you.
What do you say, Fanny?
See what the boys in the back room are
doing. Fanny's reading a book.
Excuse me.
Head is the answer we're looking for.
Yes, you know, Karen and I have been working on this thing for 5 years now. Head.
Head, okay.
How long has she been here?
All righty. So that means the score is 3-0 in favor of the current champ, and we'll go to round two. And Diane, a couple of questions there. Second and final round.
B.
All right. Here we go. Everybody plays.
Yes.
Sometimes Weird Willie would go out on his terrace and blank on the people below. Sometimes Weird Willie would go out on his terrace and blank on the people below.
Oh, the weird kid.
You're not playing?
Of course I'm playing.
She's not playing.
You like this game?
I love it.
You like this game? All right, Brett and Charles.
One second. Huh? What could take so long?
Come on. Yeah, what?
Well, it doesn't take so long. It's just a note.
Okay,
I'm
all
sorry,
set.
I didn't mean to attack.
Now, Diane, sometimes Weird Willie would go out on his terrace and blank on the people below.
Tinkle.
You heard her answer, Orson.
Yes. Diane
right
Jones. Are your mother and father out there, Diane Jones? Well, it's a shame because they won't see me match you.
He had the same answer.
Okay, Brett.
Only a girl who was not a mother would say that.
What would a mother say?
A mother would say McDee-Dee.
Yeah. What did your mother say, Charles?
I refuse to do what those two have done.
Hand it to you.
It's make wee wee.
All right.
Oh, Patty.
I hesitate
I like
to ask
Patty.
Abby Dalton,
people on the
who
top
has
row.
Led this sophisticated life of the Hollywood glamour set for so long. What is your answer?
Well, I haven't been on a show that long. I would never say a thing. Honestly, I wouldn't. And I didn't know how weird he really was. I said spy.
He spied on the people below. Yeah.
Boo! I was the only nice one here.
Nice guys don't win ball games.
All right, two of them are going to mix it up.
She's so rough.
I'll put my money on Abby.
It's interesting.
She's wiry.
What
do you say?
I am absolutely, and it's pretty unpleasant to be down here while the three of you. That's disgusting.
I mean, really.
Down below.
What a person with class would do on people below is spit.
Okay.
Right on.
Now. Fanny, Weird Willie, go out on his terrace and blank on the people below. You've heard some of the other answers.
I have heard.
What did they say in Alabama?
Unusual preoccupation with body functions that are totally repugnant to me. I said vomit. No, I said spit.
Spit is her answer. Okay. So at this moment, the score is tied, and we've got to stop and do something else here. And this is what we've got to do for you.
GSN presents Behind the Blank. In 1962, Charles Nelson Reilly won a Tony Award on Broadway for his performance in which hit play? Was it How to Succeed in Business, Hello Dolly, The Odd Couple, or Come Blow Your Horn? Stay tuned for the answer. In 1962, Charles Nelson Reilly won a Tony Award for his performance in which hit play? The answer is A, How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying. He was also nominated for a Tony in the original 1964 production of Hello, Dolly. Stay tuned for more of that 70s hour on GSN.
Okay. We're in the middle of our second and final round. The score is tied at the moment. You can untie it. One match will win the game, Karen. Here we go, and it'll be your fifth game. Are you ready? Charles, you do not play. Who else? And neither does Richard nor Fanny.
I'm not surprised.
Okay.
You're down to the
Here's a TV guide listing. Tuesday night, CBS, Cannon. Cannon breaks up a marijuana smuggling ring and blanks the evidence. No help from the audience. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but it may be a rotten answer. No, TV guide listing, Tuesday night, CBS, Cannon. Cannon breaks up a marijuana smuggling ring and blanks the evidence. Ready, Brett? All she needs is one to win the game here. All right, now we'll call on Karen for her response. CBS Cannon. Cannon breaks up a marijuana smuggling ring and blanks the evidence.
Smokes the evidence.
Smokes the evidence. All right. One puff wins the game.
I've had a few puffs in my day.
Go ahead, Orson.
This old gay woman is a juggernaut, I tell you. Smoke!
Smoke!
Smokes all the way.
Here we go again. Well, Diane, I'm sorry to see you go. You're
I have fun.
You did have a good time.
Yeah, I have kids next time I come back.
Okay. All right, Diane Jones, we got for you backstage. She was a grand sport, wasn't she?
She really was.
It was a shame to send her away, really.
That's right. Yes, indeed. Empty-handed.
Yeah.
Now you're going to have a go at over $5,000 here, Karen, again.
Okay.
We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Blank bean. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. $250 for the next one, $100 for the next one. Which three celebrities would you like some help from?
Fanny.
Green bean.
Green bean?
They always hate me. Why do they hate my ass?
They don't hate you. Okay, there's one.
Richard.
Orson Bean.
No.
Okay.
And Orson.
String.
String Bean.
Oh,
so you
yes.
have String Bean, Green Bean, and Orson Bean.
What part of the country?
Now, we have to call for an answer from you. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
String Bean.
String Bean. That's an answer that Orson Bean gave you. Our beans are getting all mixed up here. Okay, we're looking for String Bean. May we see the $100 response? Jumping Bean. Mexican jumping beans, yeah. That's a good answer. Okay, still looking for String Bean. Here is the $250 response. Jelly Bean. Oh, that's a peach of an answer. That was a good audience we had here.
Jelly and...
compared to the...
Those are the three I had written down.
They are, really.
String, jelly, and jumping.
Okay, here's your last
easy
chance for String Bean.
Now.
May we see the $500 response? String Bean!
Eat
idea.
Your heart out, O.J.
Congratulations. So, you're up to $10,600, and because you've won the $500, you're going to play for 10 times that amount. To collect the $5,000, remember, you have to match one. Has to be exact. Which one will it be?
Fanny,
you're up. You get ready to write. Karen will face me.
If she matches, I think she's the all-time champion.
Will that be a new high?
Yes.
It will be a new high
Thanks.
If she wins the $5,000.
It will be.
I work so well under pressure.
Yes.
But don't be pressured, Fanny.
Here it is. Dead blank. Dead blank. Okay, she's finished. Now, what would you say to match Fanny Flagg and filling in this blank? Dead?
Body.
Body? Got a little O from the audience here. Of course, they could be wrong. All right, you've tried to match Fanny with the answer dead body for $5,000. Fanny, may we see your card?
Oh, I'm sorry, honey. I put dead weight.
Dead weight. Was there dead, you know, there's dead duck and
dead And that's
dead
what you are now,
wood.
Sweetheart.
Dead
wood. Weight.
Yeah. Okay, now you're up to $10,600. You're going to meet another player, but first we've got to do a little business with the players out in the field there. So you come right back.
Today's consolation prizes are Mr. Coffee and Joe DiMaggio. Brew a great cup of coffee in just seconds, Mr. Coffee. And Hanes Ultra Sheer Pantyhose. Now sheerer than ever to make your legs silkier, smoother, and slinkier. Sheer elegance every step of the way. And Woodcrafter Furniture Polish to give you real paste wax shine and protection. Woodcrafter Hand Rub Beauty in a Spray. From border to border and ship to shore, give me Match Game 74 in a minute.
Ready to start another game here? Have you pulled yourself together, Karen?
Yes.
All right, then let's introduce your new challenger. Here is Susan Underwood.
Yay!
All right, Susan. Where are you from?
Well, I'm from Fountain Valley and down by the beach, and I'm married to a very wonderful man in the second row out there.
Right.
And I have a 2.5-year-old little boy who takes up most of my time.
Well. Okay, Susan, good luck to you. She's had a lot of good luck. She's got over $10,000 to her credit. Let's start the game. Would you please make a selection?
I'd like B, please.
B is for Susan Underwood, and here it is.
She's not married to O'Day, too, is she?
No. Her husband's in the second row out there somewhere. Where's he?
The second row?
In the middle. Oh, there he is, right out there. Okay. There he is, the fellow with the glasses and the yellow... Okay. All right. Are you're rooting, right? Okay. The Godfather didn't have any decorations for the Christmas tree, so he hung blank from it. The Godfather didn't have any decorations for the Christmas tree, so he hung blank from it.
What was that? You
quick
finished?
You were, dear.
All finished already, huh? Well, you're such a fast writer. No, I wouldn't say that. You finished? Oh, sweetie, you look finished to me.
Ready, Charles? Okay, now we'll call on Susan Underwood. The Godfather didn't have any decorations for the Christmas tree, so he hung blank from it.
Spaghetti.
Good answer.
What a good answer.
That would be very attractive, I think, don't you?
I love the thought of it.
If it was cooked.
If it was cooked, it would be nice and soft and hang around and...
I think it's a wonderful answer. Yeah, the Godfather has a huge tree and he hangs bodies from it.
He hangs bodies from it. I see. Brett?
I don't know why he didn't go out and buy some decorations. He's so cheap. No offense to you. Don't come after me.
Don't show it. I'm leaving the show.
Wait a minute. Give me a knife.
Guard!
I want to hire a killer.
Miss Brown, she's on the rug.
Fingers!
Okay, all right. They're both rotten answers. Charles, give us a good answer.
Susan, please excuse them. Spaghetti.
Spaghetti, okay. How about a little pasta from you, my dear?
No, the whole thing is really disgusting to me, that it's bodies.
Bodies,
dead
it is.
Bodies, yes. Lots of them.
Okay, are you offering fettuccine or anything like that?
No, however, I am offering a weekend in Tijuana for two. I happen to know he hung bullets.
Bullets from
sparkly bullets.
Sparkly bullets, yeah. Must have been then made
a
gay
tree down and blow your brains out.
What did you say, Fanny?
Before I give my answer, I want to say that some of my best friends are Italians. I said bodies.
Okay. Spaghetti was the answer she was looking for. It came up once, and now let's see how Karen does with her first round question, which is as follows.
Yes.
When little Lulu's boyfriend left her for another girl, little Lulu laughed and laughed because she knew that that little girl was a little blank. That's the most complicated question we've ever had.
I know that answer.
I'm going to send you a night letter, Karen O'Day, and I guess I'll do it one more time.
Don't bother. I've already figured it out and have my name in the slot.
Really? I'm going to do it for Karen. When little Lulu's boyfriend left her for another girl... Little Lulu laughed and laughed because she knew that that little girl was a little blank. Did you hear all that? Okay, you think about it while they're finishing up. And...
Charles, darling, what happened to you, sweetheart, after all those cheap promises?
Is that a flounder?
What?
I don't know. It was early this morning.
Oh, I see. All right, Karen. Did you... You heard the thing when little Lulu laughed and laughed because she knew that that little girl was a little...
Boy.
Boy.
What?
Little Lulu laughed and laughed because she knew that that little girl was a little boy.
Oh.
You didn't get it, did you?
No.
Oh, well, then what'd you write?
I wrote that the little girl was a little tease.
Oh.
Therefore, the little boy's expectations would be dashed.
I see. Brett, what did you write?
Stay tuned.
He's always doing his autobiography. I said little boy.
Little boy's a match. Okay.
Two little boys.
That's the answer.
Three little boys.
Karen, are you offering a little boy?
No, I'm offering one huge big boy.
Big boy.
In Tijuana.
What is your offering, Fanny?
Oh, I don't want to say.
You don't want to say?
No, I got confused. I said, I don't know why I said it, actually.
I
said it. What was the question?
I didn't get mixed up.
Because she knew that that little girl was a little...
Cartoon.
Little cartoon.
Which makes no sense.
Little Lulu. Cartoon. So
that's mixed up. I'm wrong.
Well, she spelled it right this time anyway. Right. Look at it that way.
So at the end of round one, it's 4-1 in favor of Karen O'Day, our current champion. And round two coming up. But first, this is coming up. A little message for you.
Here we are. Right.
We're ready to... I didn't know which camera was coming out there over there. So here I am. Well, the time is up, ladies. We're going to stop right here at the end of round one. 4-1 is the score. We'll pick it up next time at this exact point. And I thank you. Each and every one was absolutely splendid in his and her own way.
Could I just...
Oh, you don't have to thank them.
He has something that... No,
well, no, I just... If I seemed a little down, I have a reason.
Why is that?
You had dinner at our house.
Yes.
Remember the big white Persian cat snowball?
Oh, yeah, beautiful.
Oh, we were mowing our lawn today, and the lawnmower was dripping gasoline and making brown spots on it, and... Gary got a saucer, you know, to catch that gas. We went to drain it out, get a can. The cat came and drank the gasoline. And just ran around the garden, screeching, went right up a tree and just dropped down stiff.
Dead?
No, just out of gas.
Oh. Next time we get together, we're going to have this group of ding-a-lings with us, so here they are.
I would refuse to strike.
Nipsey Russell, Russ Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Jackie Joseph, Richard Dawson, and Joanne Wallace.
Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Thank you. Bye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.